From the beautiful Capistrano Valley Performing Arts Center, it's Breakfast with Gary and Kelly, with special guest, sax man Vincent Ingala. And now, Gary and Kelly.
Oh my God! Ah! Ah! We take a picture! You guys look great!
I'll see, she's taking a picture.
Yay! Oh, I was going to do a video.
I know. Thanks for being here, you guys.
Wow.
Huh? What do you think? How do you like?
You like?
Isn't this gorgeous?
Kind of fun.
Pretty crazy that we are here today. We're so glad that you're all here with us, too. And boy, this is a high school. This is a high school theater. Can you believe?
No, it's not. This is a performing arts theater.
It really is.
But it's on a high school campus.
It's phenomenal.
We should thank them too.
Absolutely.
Thank you so much to the Capo Valley Performing Arts Theater and the
Dr. Kevin Astor, the principal, whose father for you local media folks is Art Astor. Isn't that funny?
If anybody's in the radio world,
yes, they know that name. And Rick Nichols, the theater manager, and Craig Landino, the digital media instructor here, who have been so instrumental in helping us, you know, kind of wed up. The fun thing is that we've got some high school students that are helping as interns on this thing too now. So it's all a really nice little meshing of.
And we have Saddleback College's film crew here,
exactly,
headed up by Mark Crewman. And so you see the people behind the cameras.
It's a great collaboration.
Our film crew. So. Yeah. Yeah. Thanks to Saddleback College.
And then there's us. So, you know, really, it ain't all good, you know, but what are you going to do? But here's the thing, because to kick this off today, we've got a young guy who, this is the kid that could pass as a high school student, but he is, he's a brilliant, brilliant musician, and really kind of rocketed onto the scene a couple years ago in San Diego during the Lemonade Weekend.
And
it was kind of salvaging what had intended to be the Smooth Jazz Awards.
Yes.
And that fizzled out, but then he tore it up.
That was when Graham was born, so it was 3 years ago in
March. Okay, there you go.
Ago in March.
This is his latest CD, but he is at work on a new one that will be coming out shortly. We'll hear all about that, but better than that, he's going to be here with us for the next hour and playing. Please welcome Vincent Ingala.
Thank you.
Wow is right.
Wow. Wow.
Nice.
I just can't believe I'm here.
I can't either. I can't honestly think of a better guest to kick off this thing here at this new home.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
I really mean it.
I am so honored. I can't even tell you. I'm so honored.
It is all ours. It is all ours.
I'm with Gary and Kelly. Breakfast with Gary and Kelly. What's better than this?
And we met you 3 years ago, March 13th, I believe it was.
The Lemonade Weekend.
Oh, you have a good memory. I wouldn't remember that date to save my life.
The only reason why I remembered it was because my grandson was born that morning.
Oh,
and it was like, okay.
We helped deliver him, and then we drove down to San Diego. It was unbelievable.
I got the phone call. I'm like, you're where? You're at the hospital now? Oh, my gosh.
We had Norm scrub up, and then everything was fine after that.
It was... So we met you then, and you were just starting out, or did you have, what were you doing 3 years ago?
That was 2010.
That was
like 4 or 5 years ago.
No way.
Oh, no, I'm sorry.
No, it was 2013.
It was 2011.
Okay, wait a minute. What's today?
We got to get our dates right here.
My God, is there a math instructor in the house?
This is a high school.
I'm so bad at math. You can't go up and be.
Right there.
No, but what I was doing
was,
it was my first time ever out in California playing.
That's right.
It was a showcase at the now distinct anthology.
Unfortunately. Right.
The different levels. They had three
But
levels.
That was an awesome venue.
It was a
and
great
that was
place.
The first what time.
A shame that it, you know.
I know.
Go figure.
It's too bad. But anyway, that was my first time playing in California. They put a showcase together.
Right.
An anthology, if you recall.
I do. And that was kind of a scramble thing to make up for.
Well, they put it together last minute because of the
Jazz Awards.
The awards thing crashed and burned.
Right.
And then, but everybody was out here from all over the country.
And so they came up with this motto. They said, let's make lemonade out of lemons.
Exactly.
Right, exactly.
And so they called a bunch of artists in last minute. Mostly, you know, they donated their time. And, you know, we all came together. We felt propelled to do this. But I was scheduled to do the showcase anyway in conjunction with the Oasis Smooth Jazz Awards.
Yeah.
But it got canceled. I still came out.
Yes.
We still did the show at Anthology.
Yes.
And I met you guys there.
Yes.
I met so many people there that day.
We had you on the radio.
That's right.
I remember
going
backstage and talking to your mom.
That's right.
Now, where did you come from? Where did you fly out from?
Well, I was born and raised in a small little town called Prospect, Connecticut.
There you go.
And
balmy Prospect, Connecticut.
No, I love it. I love it.
It's cold coming on.
Well, it's very cold there now. That's true.
By the way, hi to Mom and Dad.
My parents are watching back in Connecticut, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah, they are.
Yay.
Yeah, they are.
As well as my whole family and
your fans.
Tons of family.
By the way, you did good. He came out great, right? He did very nice.
Thank you.
They should be very proud. They should be very proud of you.
Thank you. They wish they could be here.
That's okay.
And they are here in spirit.
Yeah, exactly.
But they will physically be out here in 2 weeks.
Oh, perfect.
Yes.
Nice.
They're going to come visit.
They come out often?
They come out when they can. Well, I just moved out here.
That's right.
5 months ago from the East Coast.
Ooh.
Yeah.
So and how do you like
this? Is this your first time living away from
first
home?
First time living alone, away from parents.
Yeah.
So I'm fresh out of the bag,
So you got 2 weeks to clean up.
I'm a good boy. I'm not a troublemaker.
What's your apartment like? Do you have a house cleaner, I hope? I mean, do you have a...
I'm my house cleaner.
Oh, okay. All right.
No, you'd be scared if you went in my apartment. It's immaculate.
Really?
OCD. You know. It's very clean.
That OCD comes in handy sometimes.
It's very clean. I know.
Sometimes.
I like it, though. I like
how
it that way.
Fun.
Well, they taught me well. My mother taught me how to...
Exactly.
Not only clean, she taught me how to cook.
Oh, my gosh.
Now, I'm a good cook, you know.
Really?
Italian kid that knows how to cook.
I got to know how to
mange
a mange here. I make Italian
dishes.
That's
right, exactly.
And so how old are you?
I'm 22.
Okay, and are you single? Are you got a girlfriend?
Are you single? Have you been married before?
Have you been married?
No. That's not a crazy question to ask on Valentine's Day.
I know, I'm just saying.
Which, by the way, happy Valentine's Day to everybody.
Exactly, happy Valentine's Day.
And thank you for spending your Valentine's Day with us.
There's probably a lot of people out there were wondering these questions.
Yes,
I
know.
That's
what
I'm here for.
I'm not seeing anybody currently.
Okay, well, you hear that, right? Okay.
See?
The word is out now, so.
So, walk us through that whole thing from the Smooth Jazz Weekend, because you know the Lemonade Weekend, because I think it's really funny. It was the first time you'd been out here. You were brought out. You had a CD out at that point, right?
I released my first album, North End Soul, in 2010.
Okay.
And so this was approximately...
Yeah, maybe a year after then or something.
See, was it 2012 or what? It was 2011.
Oh, man.
It was 2011. No, it was 2011.
I'm positive this March.
Okay.
11, 12, 13, 14...
15.
He can't be 4.
Oh, my God. I withdraw the question,
is
really.
Is he going to be 4?
Request to treat as a hostile witness,
it's
Your Honor.
Time is flying.
Is he going to be 4, Gary? sad. I don't know. How old
it's
my
not. It really, it's
maybe?
Not important.
Anyhow.
Okay, go ahead.
Let's talk about arc welding for a while, shall we?
No, my first album, North and Soul, was out for about a year.
Okay.
And, you know, when I released it, I didn't really expect anything to happen. I was playing out locally on the weekends, every weekend, the local restaurants, clubs, bars.
Sure.
I had a local following, you know, kind of like this cult thing, and a lot of friends and family, and they would all come support me every weekend. Yeah. I did that all through high school.
Really?
Yeah. No, my teenage years were spent playing.
Yeah.
I wouldn't trade it for anything.
In clubs.
That's all I wanted to do.
Yeah, if
in
you
clubs.
Know what you want to do,
restaurants,
that's
clubs.
What you do.
I was performing, I loved it, I was making music.
You get
music.
A sax, you get a fake ID, you're good to go.
Well, it was not like that. It was all my parents, friends, and family, and you know, people, fans that I've picked up, you know, from playing back home.
Were your parents musical inclined?
No. I mean, my whole family is musical in the sense that they love music. My father was a disc jockey back in the day.
Oh.
He was spinning in the clubs. Oh. Back in the day, I said. You notice that? And so I grew up with a massive record collection.
Oh, wow.
I grew up listening to tons of, you know, funk, soul, R&B. You know, those 12-inch singles, you know. I could say that I actually grew up.
12-inch singles?
I could actually say I grew up with vinyl.
Oh.
There you go.
Because when I was young, all I would do was, yes.
Yay.
And I'm proud of that. I'm proud of that. But all I would do when I was young was just.
45s?
Yes, 45s, 33s.
73s?
Put them on my father's turntable. And I would just listen to everything I can.
Wow.
But it started with doo-wop, 50s, Elvis, Beatles, 60s. Then it progressed.
You. Look at this kid.
I love all types of music. I really do.
That's good.
That's
to have it all
that's
around.
Good stuff.
So when did you pick up the sax? Or did you not pick up the sax? Was it another instrument?
Well, drums was what I first started on.
Really?
Four or
5 years old?
Well, my parents, they bought me like this little baby kit. And I like beat it up so bad, I think.
Whose idea was it? I'm really curious
on
this.
I would never let my kid
drum. Where does the parents go, this is a great idea, we've got a 4-year-old, let's get him something he can make a lot of noise with.
Well,
because really, seriously.
Honestly, I think my mother was tired of me banging on the pots and pans. they had to do something.
Yeah, right, we did that. All we used to take the pots and pans out, and you would hit the pots and pans.
Yeah. No, that's right.
Wow.
So okay. That first kit was like gone in 6 months. I beat that up, you know, into shreds.
Yeah.
But then, it, you know, it's funny because it's kind of like a domino effect from there.
Mm-hmm.
I moved on to the guitar. That my grandmother bought me a starter guitar.
There you go.
One of those Costco specials or, you know, whatever.
God
but
bless.
No, but I, you know.
Yeah, absolutely.
If you love something enough.
Oh, yeah.
You make it a priority to learn it and you absorb.
Did you take lessons?
I took a few guitar lessons for about 6 months.
Okay.
That did help.
Yeah.
Looking back on that, it taught me to associate notes with pitch.
Right.
You know, very interesting.
Right.
Like, this is a C, this is an A, this is a
but
B.
But drums, you didn't take drum lessons.
No, drums are, even internally inside me today, drums are like,
yeah,
I'm always air drumming, or I was always getting in trouble in school, drumming on the desk. The teacher would get so mad at me. But
the kid had in front
I
of
I always
you.
Have, like, this eternal rhythm in me. It's weird.
Wow.
But
do you just play by ear then? If you've not had much in the way of lessons,
I mostly played by ear my whole life.
Yeah,
with everything.
Good for you. That's hard.
Wow.
I mean, that's difficult.
Well, it's funny. It's like people ask sometimes how does it feel? I mean, what is it like?
Yeah.
Just knowing a note or.
Your mom must have played a lot of music while she
that
had you in the womb.
Yeah.
Well, they save.
That's
they
awesome.
Say there's something to that.
I know.
But you know, the only thing I could compare it to, it's like a sixth sense. That's really the best thing I can say. It's just like,
wow.
You just know it. It's a natural thing. And, you know, it's the same as athletes.
Right.
Just some people, sports come to them. No matter what you do, we are all wired a certain way for certain things. We all have things that we are well at, you know, and shine through on, and things that we love.
Mine's about to show up any day now.
I'm still looking for mine. I don't know what mine is yet.
I don't know. Well, I can't. Do what you guys do. You look at you guys how to do a show like this and talk, and it's unbelievable.
Oh, well, we do this every day, though.
This is where the big money is right here.
Yeah, but not everybody can do that. It's all perception. So.
We are.
How
God,
fun.
This guy is like
is it time to take a break?
Smart guy. It's unbelievable.
We don't have to take a break already, do we?
Yeah, we do.
No,
yeah, we do. I got to go lay down. I'm depressed already. This is terrible. we're gonna take a break and come back. With Vincent Ingala, he's going to play and
awesome.
Stick around here on Breakfast with Gary and Kelly.
Yeah.
Whoa. Sorry. She's got away from me there.
Woo. Kelly was into the cooking sherry before the show. So.
Sorry.
It's all right. Vincent Ingala's here, everybody. Mr. and Mrs. Ingala, you did great.
Look.
He's a great kid.
He's a wonderful kid.
He's going to play for us. We're all on the same show. Why don't we stand by him?
I don't know.
What are you going to do here, man?
Well, the first song I played was the title track from this album.
Exactly. That's right.
Go to track number two now.
Track number two. Well, let's keep it.
If I Could Fly.
If I Could Fly. Vincent Ingala.
Thank you.
and Breakfast with Gary and Kelly.
Wow.
Nice.
Wow.
Outstanding.
Woo!
I like it, kids.
Woo!
What a great audience.
Man.
Fantastic.
Yeah,
audience.
It's a great group, isn't it?
Man, oh man, oh man.
And what a beautiful venue.
Isn't this pretty?
Congratulations, you guys. First time.
Thanks.
Couldn't ask for a better spot to do the show.
Yeah, absolutely. We're as bewildered by this as you are. I can tell you.
Well, I'm excited for you guys.
Oh,
and I have
thanks.
To say, I feel like, you know, this is a new experience for me. I'm on the either David Letterman or Howard Stern or something. Well, not Howard Stern.
Yeah, from hell. Letterman this, from hell or
well,
something.
This is fun.
We're on Breakfast with Gary and Kelly.
I'm on the best show. I'm the show that's better than those two.
Oh,
Gary,
that's very sweet.
Well, that's very sweet. I wanted to ask you, you've been around a lot of places since we met you, like
right.
when you started coming out. And name some of the places, I mean, because I know you're now at the Dave Koz Lounge.
Dave Koz Lounge in Beverly Hills.
Right.
Yeah, brand new Spaghettini, they just opened up in Beverly Hills.
What are you doing there?
They've had some interesting folks stopping by for
just for lunch and dinner.
Oh,
yeah,
man.
It's a whole different animal than Seal Beach. And some of you that are probably already familiar with the Seal Beach location.
It's a great place.
So what are you doing there?
It's a great place.
But they built a new one.
What are you doing there?
I am hosting the Sunday brunch.
Oh.
I will be there every Sunday with my band.
How fun.
And it's on 184 North Cannon Drive. It's an absolutely beautiful spot. I encourage everybody to stop by.
Where else have you been?
Check it out.
I mean, I know you've been around the world because if you remember correctly, we did walk the streets of Sorrento, Italy.
That's
together.
Right. That's right.
You remember?
That's
on
right.
The Dave Koz cruise. We were like walking around and he goes, oh, hey, hi, I know you. And I go, oh, yeah, you're Vince. He's like, oh, yeah. So we just walked around together.
I know, and I knew you were in Italy. Go figure.
In Sicily.
Yeah.
I'm Sicilian. Well, my family has ties to.
I couldn't go to Sicily.
Oh, funny.
I was quarantined.
That was a beautiful. Oh, yes.
We'll talk about that later.
She was quarantined.
Were you on that cruise? No, you weren't.
No, I was on probation. I don't know when I was on the watch list. I wasn't allowed to leave the country. I don't like to talk about it. Thanks. Let's not bring it up anymore.
We don't go there with Gary.
So exactly.
You've been to Italy? Where else?
Italy, we did the cruise. Okay. Saw you. There's a lot of beautiful, classic Southern California festivals, venues. Catalina Island Jazz Festival.
Yeah,
right.
That's a fun one.
Beautiful.
That's a fun one.
And that's in my neck of the woods now because I'm in Long Beach. So I could practically walk to where you take the boat.
Yeah. Long Beach is great, isn't it?
I love Long Beach. It's like the best.
It really is. It really is. There's no question about it.
Long Beach.
One pitiful applaud for Long Beach.
One fan. That's great. Okay.
All right. Okay, so the word hasn't gotten out yet, but it's...
Well, that's because it's the best kept secret.
It really is. It really is.
Hyatt Regency Newport Beach Jazz Festival,
right.
Another beautiful festival.
Have you been around the country? I mean, have you played the B.B. King place over there in New York?
I haven't played B.B. King's yet, but I was in London in October, played Peach Express.
Oh, there's a great...
Jonathan Fritzen and I, we did a package this year, a keyboard
player
in Sweden.
Yeah.
And we did our first engagement at the Peach Express. It was my first time there. Absolutely incredible. Beautiful venue.
Boy, there's some ghosts on that stage, huh?
The venue is so, it's got a mystique to it.
Yeah.
You go downstairs and like this old little nightclub, but it's nice. All the best jazz clubs across the country are these, you know, very. Yeah.
Well, being back east, you had exposure to that. I mean, I don't know, did you play in the city at all, in New York?
No, not so much New York.
Really?
A little different scene.
Yeah, yeah.
I think that's more straight ahead jazz.
Well, true.
You know, I think I tend to lean more on the R&B side.
Yeah, yeah.
And let's face it, the genre of smooth jazz, as we know it, lives out here in Southern California.
Yeah,
so
it's true.
Really?
It's really true.
No better place
really?
To be than right here in Southern California.
It's really true. I know you don't want to belabor it, but I got to tell you, if I were your folks, I'd be so thrilled that you have that steady gig over at Spags for your first time being out here on your own. I mean, what a great blessing
it's a great experience, and we get to play to virtually a different audience every week. And, you know, I'm not just doing all sax. I do a little guitar. I sing.
Mm-hmm.
I do a
You sing?
I do.
Really?
I do, a little bit, yes.
Oh.
Now, I'm a hacker singer. I consider myself. But, but it's like a nice variety show, and I blend all the music and all the influences that I grew up with. I do a little 50s. I do a little Louis Prima. I do a little...
Nice!
You
nice.
Know, but I throw in the R&B and the guitar, and sometimes I even
like
get on the drums.
Me.
It's fun. It's nice.
Do you speak Italian?
Well, I know a few words, but
he cooks, he cleans, he sings.
No, I'm thinking, did not speak Italian.
He's such a nice boy.
He's such a nice
boy. He's such
boy.
A good boy.
Yeah, that's right,
I
exactly.
I would have pinched your cheek.
Exactly. My God.
I'm so a good. Mom, I can do that.
And I tell you, I make a killer sauce.
Really?
Ah, there you go.
Sunday sauce.
There you go. Yes. All right.
Is it red or white?
No, it's red.
Ooh.
Yes.
Yeah, of course.
That's one thing
white
I, you know,
sauce.
When I came out here.
What are you
here,
talking about, Kelly? Come
we
on.
Had, you know, you never know.
Linguine and clams.
Exactly.
Well,
white
yeah,
sauce.
But I mean.
And we just had we lobster something.
That smelled very.
That
smelled,
that, was.
That smelled very good. By
oh
the
well,
way.
I stand corrected by the food expert. So.
What was that sauce called?
Lobster something. Lobster something or other.
Yeah.
Yeah, exactly.
It was a
which
white
which smelled
sauce.
Very good. By
wasn't
the way.
That good?
Yes.
It tasted very
yes.
good too.
Yes.
So, who are some of the folks that have been dropping into the Spags? I mean, do some name dropping. You've seen.
It's you know, it's incredible. They've only been open for about 8 weeks.
Yeah.
And already, Johnny Mathis has stopped down to sing.
Tom Jones.
Sir Tom Jones last
yes.
week was in, having dinner with George Hamilton. I mean. You can't make this up. It's just
it's really true.
Taylor Dane.
Did I see Annie Lennox in there too?
Annie
is that,
Lennox.
Yeah.
Larry Carlton. Oh. Evelyn Champagne King. It's
oh,
just it's just an absolutely phenomenal venue.
Yeah.
And the thing about it is they bring in world class acts mm-hmm. and entertainment
mm-hmm.
and you get to experience their show in this intimate venue.
Sure.
You really can't go anywhere else and see.
We were thinking about having our show there.
Let me tell you, that would be great to broadcast there once a week.
A TV show.
Or do like a special once a month thing straight from the Beverly
yeah.
Hills location.
Yeah, because they really, they were hoping Kelly would come and do some cooking for them. So.
I could cook.
What was that?
I can cook.
Hey.
I want to hear what's going on. You got a new CD. How far along are we? Where are we with this?
I have a new record coming out in a few months, shooting for April.
Okay.
I'm very excited
Ooh.
About it.
It's a good thing. It's a good thing.
I'm due. It'll be about 3 years this summer.
Yeah. Yeah.
But I took my time on it. You know, I don't good. Rush it because, you know, once you release something into the world,
yeah.
it's permanent.
Yeah, you've got some people on here that we know.
Yeah, Greg Kroukas.
And Greg Kroukas.
Played piano on my
Greg's
record.
Greg's great.
We collaborated
what a,
on a song.
What an amazing guy he is, huh?
Fantastic. Wow. I grew up listening to Greg's music. My parents were listeners of this genre.
Really?
They were playing that around the house when I was growing up.
Yeah.
So I think subconsciously that grew on me.
Yeah.
To some extent.
Kind of mold you that way.
Yeah. And Jonathan Fritzen and I.
Who's going to be on this one? Anybody you can say?
Know, I don't think I'm at liberty to say that.
Okay.
Yet.
Yeah. Well, you know, you have to. Well, ask.
I mean, what do you need? You play everything yourself. I mean,
well,
you know.
Yeah, you do.
Right?
Well, that's my whole life I've always been into, you know, programming and I want to start producing for other artists. I love the studio just as much as I do playing live.
So,
I really do.
Wow.
So on some of these, do you play the drums?
I do drum programming, and on this new record, I do the programming as well. Some
and
live
guitars?
Drums. Yes. I layer all the instruments
yeah.
on top
yeah.
of each other. I that's something I've always done since a young age. I it's called multi-tracking.
Yeah, right.
I love that. I love that.
Amazing.
And it's a lot of fun yeah, to see how a song just magically comes together.
Like a one-man band.
Well, I mean, it's unbelievable what we could do.
Yeah.
Today's
yeah.
day and age with the technology and the studios we have,
yeah.
you can make a record on a computer
mm-hmm.
in your basement. That's what mm-hmm. I did. in so many words.
So neater.
Did you have a Kickstarter campaign, or how did
no.
you?
No, I'm self-released.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow. Okay, so I really like this picture. You
Thank
see
you.
This? What are you thinking here? You know?
You'd be very surprised.
Yeah.
I
think,
you're contemplating something.
Looks like I'm concentrating to get a good photo right
yeah.
there. That is actually, a lot of people don't realize this, that picture was taken in my living room.
This is your living room?
See, if that was couch. Taken in my living room, you'd be thinking, hey, I wonder if that Cheeto's still okay to eat out the floor.
Well, I could have been looking at something like
yeah,
that.
Right.
The dog.
Exactly.
There was a table right in front there.
Exactly.
Like, there could have been But
nice
but I'm really excited about this new record. It's taking a little different approach. It's a lot more deeper into the R&B realm. A lot
nice.
Of potential for crossing
nice.
Over a little bit and
nice.
A lot more vocals, horns.
Good
so
for you.
It's more of the same. It's not a drastic like concept record. More of the same but a little more cutting edge R&B,
April?
Which I'm
April?
Very yeah.
R&B is good.
Just being R&B true to
good.
True
That's
to the music.
Yeah,
all.
Right exactly.
True
exactly.
To myself.
How do you write? Are you, and I'm especially curious if you play more by ear, you know, as opposed to, I mean.
It's a little different. Sometimes I come up with a melody first and then build a track off that.
Mm-hmm.
But most of the times I get a track going first and I like the groove and I say, this sounds good. And then usually I could hear a melody over that. That's more or less how these songs come together.
Yeah. Yeah.
But I mean, you have to have the groove happening first.
Yeah.
That's very important.
And then how do you name them? I mean,
I'm really not the best song namer.
Yeah?
I really don't. You know, everybody has different, you know, visions and what a song, you know, does to them, you know, how they convey it.
Like, yeah. If I Could Fly.
Well, that's the song I just kicked off the first segment.
Song, yeah.
Segment, TV. I didn't say set.
Very impressive.
Segment.
Yeah,
thank you.
Nice.
I'm learning. You're teaching me well. I just figured, you know, if I ever could fly, that would be the soundtrack
playing.
Like if I was in the air going over the city at night flying. You know, that's why I went like that at one point. It's like I'm flying. When the piano goes, uh-huh.
See, I wrote a song very similar to that. Mine is If I Could Parallel Park. So it really, it's not quite as catchy. There's a lot of this.
I wish I could parallel park.
I don't know.
So, you know, and it's really up to the listener to decide.
Well, I was flying with you, and I was like, oh, that's a really good title.
Ding, 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 ding. It's like, you know, it's like.
Don't get Kelly singing. Don't get Kelly singing.
You didn't want me
to sing. I'm sure you're a good singer.
Oh. I don't have one musical note in my body whatsoever.
I doubt that.
Yeah. We'll talk about that
later. She can sing very well. I heard her. Uh-huh. I heard her singing backstage, warming up her vocal cords.
Sorry. Almost spit there.
So who are some of the, since you've been out here, obviously one of the real great things of being out here are all of the ridiculously talented musicians that are in this world, in this area. Who have you gotten to play with?
Anybody jump up on stage on Sundays?
Well, in fact, tomorrow Steve Oliver is going to be my special guest at the brunch.
Oh,
we're very excited about that.
Boy, he's such a unique talent too, isn't he? He
does it all.
I love him.
Vocalist, playing guitar, producer as well.
Yeah, absolutely.
In fact, we're going to collaborate. We did collaborate on a new song for a new record.
Good.
Yeah, he's a talented songwriter
as
well.
He is.
I love working with him. He's great. He's working
on a new thing too.
He is. Yeah. He is. Yeah. Wow. He's great. We have nice phone call conversations. I like talking to him. He's a great guy. But, you know, I haven't had too many guests yet at the club. We've only been open for 8 weeks.
Right.
And we're still getting it off the ground. But since I've been here,
Dave's been there, I bet.
Well, Dave Koz stops in when he can. I mean, it's the Dave Koz Lounge. So
I should hope so. He's there.
He has got up several times with me and jammed. It's great.
Can't do any better than that.
What are your hours on Sunday?
11 to 3.
Oh.
It's
3 o'clock in the afternoon?
That's a lot of breakfast sausage.
It's not traditional brunch. It's served family style.
Oh, nice.
It's not.
You know where I'm going with this, don't you?
I don't know where you're going with this.
I don't either, but.
3 p.m.?
Oh, yes. Hmm? Yes, 11 to 3. The music starts around 12:15, 12 o'clock.
Okay. Do you do anything after 3 o'clock? I mean, you have any?
No.
Really?
I go home. Oh. I'm usually shot at the end of a Sunday. I'm tired. You know, it's a long day.
Oh, man.
Plus, I ate so much food. You know, it's like. The food is so delicious.
Well, rest up for May 24th.
Oh, is that what you're cooking? Is that a hint?
That's the birthday batch. That's the date of the birthday batch.
Oh, I didn't get it until now. I get it now. I get it.
If you're in town.
Here's the proper answer. Kelly, I'm leaving at 3 o'clock and I'm shooting right down.
There you go.
Birthday bash. I will be there.
There you go. There you go.
I will be there. I can't wait. I was there 2 years ago.
Yeah.
No, 3 years ago. I didn't do it the past 2 years.
Yes.
I couldn't make it, but this year I'm excited.
Good. Oh, outstanding.
It's great.
Good.
It's always
a
blast.
I subtly did that.
Yes. Good.
You were at NAMM this past year. Was that your first time?
First time at the NAMM show.
Oh, wow.
How fun is that?
It was great. I know, and I know that you wanted me to stop by the booth.
Yeah, that's okay. No, that's okay. That, for those of you that don't know, the National Association of Music Merchants thing is the most amazing hang of the greatest players on the face of the planet. All coming with their checkbooks to check out new gear and stuff and new toys. So if you like music, if you like musical stars, and if you like gadgets, musical instruments and gear, that there's no better. It's heaven on earth, is it not?
It's like Comic-Con for musicians.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly.
It's huge. I mean, it's really not open to the public.
It's a private event.
And if you have endorsements with a company or if you belong with it, you know, you go and you network and mingle and you get to see the latest gear. It's really cool.
But at the two hotels that are right there, they always have free events that you can walk in and see, and
that's
you see musicians playing all the time.
Thousands and thousands of people.
Yeah. Who did you get to see? Anybody? I mean, Stevie Wonder is always kind of, you know.
I didn't see Stevie Wonder.
Didn't you?
I didn't see Stevie Wonder. I wish
either.
I could. You know, I didn't see anybody famous this time.
Yeah.
I went on the worst day. I went on Saturday, which is the busiest day, and when no celebrities go, because they go on Thursday or Friday.
Right, right, right.
But I didn't really quite know what I was in for. It was a crazy day.
Ugh.
The decibel level is like so loud. There's ton, especially if you go in the drum department.
Oh.
You're deaf at the end of the day.
How do you like all those? I mean, they have everything.
It's like being in Disneyland for a musician. I love
it. Yeah, it is. It totally is.
And you're meeting with musicians from all over the world, and it's very, very cool experience.
Mm-hmm.
I wish I could have seen you guys there, but it's okay.
That's okay. Totally we got you here.
One more time. This is better. This is way better.
That's great.
Vince, this is really fun.
I'm having a blast
really
with you guys.
Yeah.
We've been looking forward to doing this for so long.
Yeah, we have.
And I'm looking at the clock, and it's already time to...
I know.
Well,
we have a clock now.
Yeah, the old clock on the wall, ladies and gentlemen. we're going to take a break and come back, and Vince is going to perform for us again.
A little guitar this time.
There you go.
Ooh,
little guitar.
I've never seen you on the guitar.
Just stick around. You're on Breakfast with Gary and Kelly.
Yeah.
Come over here. Let's take a selfie. Let's do a thing. What are we doing? Look at this, nice.
You want me to take it?
Yeah.
Let me do another one.
There it is.
Woo!
My God, look at, they always cut me out of these. Damn it!
You're too tall.
You're too tall. It's like he's got to hear.
We're glad you're all in this.
Uh-oh. Oh. Keep talking.
Talk amongst yourselves. There it is.
Go.
There it is.
Woo!
Outstanding.
Yeah. Nice
outstanding.
Guitar.
I love this guitar.
It's a Gretsch. Is that Mr.? No.
Mr. Gretsch?
Mr. Gretsch? Dean? No, Dean Gretsch?
this is a guitar company from a long time.
I don't know these things. I told you, I have no musical.
Well, if you were at the NAMM show, you could have
learned. Yeah, exactly. Exactly. What are you going to do for us, man?
I'm going to do a song off the Can't Stop Now CD. This was a single in February of 2013. It's called Wish I Was There.
Oh, great song.
KSBR has been extremely supportive of this song, and I can't thank you guys enough for all your returns. But we love
you
guys.
Thank you. Vincent Ingala, everybody. Thank you so much.
So much.
Wow. My son.
This is the one right now. Can't stop now, but a new one coming shortly. Thank you so much for being here with us today.
Thank you.
We will catch you. Thanks, Vince. We'll catch you next time on Breakfast with Gary and Kelly. Yeah.